My name is Sharon Eichhorn, and I'm a single mother of four. In January of 2003 was when I moved out of my very nice, comfortable, large home, four bedroom, three bath, two car garage. You know, I had worked about 72 hours a week, pregnant, raising three children on my own, and putting my husband at that time through two drug rehabs, only to find after his second rehab he met someone in there and never came back home. I had been abandoned of a marriage of 10 years. And I didn't know where I was gonna go. I couldn't afford the $2,500 a month rent. I was at a crossroads in my life where I was desperate. I didn't have any housing. And so I found myself alone, having a baby, and now welcoming four children. We called 75 plus places. They would laugh at us. And it was just a fluke, a last resort, a sheer God, how are you gonna meet my needs? The one place that we went to, because everybody told us no over the phone, was here at Andrews Heights. Mom made a phone call to the manager at that time. We told her that we had four young children and we needed a three bedroom. And she said, I have a four bedroom available. Like we were jumping up and down, there's a four bedroom apartment? I've never heard of a four bedroom apartment. And so we walked in the door and just instantly, it was everything that I had needed and wanted and more. Andrews Heights, I think, was, was one of the very first signs that I saw how God was going to provide for me in ways that I could never imagine, because it doesn't seem logical for me to be able to have 1,500 square feet in Bellevue and pay $900. The other thing that I think is really neat is the square plaques that you have down in the play area. My kids love to hop and skip on those names, and they're always wondering, what are those names? And I'll say, those are the people that made this possible.
Things kind of fell apart after my husband had been wounded in Vietnam, and just everything sort of went wrong. But it's just fantastic to live in a safe, reasonably priced, pleasant environment.
Well, it has a large bathroom, which the other apartments don't, that you can get your wheelchair in. So it's really handy for me. So I can live by myself anyway. I don't have to live with someone and be taken care of. That's what I feel like.
It's a wonderful place to be and to have access to, and the, it's not like a nursing home, because there's no hospital facilities or anything like that. It's a residence.
The rent is cheap, the appointments are beautiful. I was just thrilled and the manager is just wonderful.
This is the first place I've lived, actually, that I felt like the owners or the management really cared. I mean, we got gifts delivered on Christmas.
I said to my husband,
that's unheard of.
Basically, we're living now within our means, whereas before, because of rent, we were barely scraping by.
I've been an at-home mom, and it's really been a blessing. With our older boy, I stayed home with him until he was preschool age, and then I worked part-time.
The other day, there was a meeting, and it came to where people in the complex said, hey, let's have a movie night. And management and ownership made that happen.
And that's what's so wonderful about such a place as this. It just could not be nicer. Surprised me, I must say. Don't know what I expected, but I didn't expect it to be this great. And that's why I write thank you notes when people hear when St. Andrews does special things. I want them to know it's appreciated.
I'm talking to them now. Yeah. If you can duplicate Ellsworth House X number of times, you're just going to, well, you're going to win a good seat in heaven.
There aren't enough words to express my sincere thank you to the people who have taken their time and their money and their prayers and their concerns to people who are in desperate need. And I hope a little bit of my story has expressed how you have touched my life and four children. At night when you go to bed, I want you to know that our children say a prayer for the people that make this home our home.